Hello and welcome back to Let's Dive In Brilliant Bob. Now, the last episode I said I wasn't going to do this again. Oh, also there's a story I missed, so enjoy the slideshow. That is the closest thing we get to an explanation as to why Bob is doing all this bad platforming. And then there's this. This is the level select screen. Instead of clicking on a level and going to it, the designers decided, hey, let's make them platform their way over to the level they want to do, and let's put this level number 2 just right in their way. Anyway, like I said, I said I wasn't gonna do this, but I realized, hey, I could use this as an opportunity to figure out how to edit videos a little bit better. Oh, also, this commentary is taking place after the gameplay, just FYI. And yeah. I really don't like this level select system. Why did they do it? I don't know. Why did they make any of the decisions they made? Why is the camera controlled by Q and E? You know, why are the circular platforms slippery like they're made out of ice? So, for this level 11, the way I edited it together is pretty much just for all the failures. Well, except for the first time around, like this one. I left in the whole run, but then for all the... I just cut it down to me dying, and then in the order of which I... didn't really change the order at all, and then I, So enjoy this montage of me dying before I finally figure out how to, beat the level. Thank you. So, this is me not believing that there's no way to, no better way to control the camera. Going back to options to see if there's some sort of control scheme you can switch up, even though I've done this before, thinking, maybe I was wrong all those other times, and then of course there's the, rather than just go back right into level 11, you gotta platform your way over to level 11. Managed to do it without incident this time around. But it's still really annoying. So, more montage of me dying. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
So this is level 12, and I edited it together in much the same way. So once again, oh, and then this part where it's supposed to show you where everything is didn't really help me at all. But once again, enjoy a nice montage of me falling to my death repeatedly. Okay, so now for this level, I did it a little bit differently. Instead of keeping my deaths in the order in which they occurred, I switched them around, so the run-throughs where I didn't get very far all happened first, and then as it goes on, I'll be further and further along, even though that's not the order in which the deaths occurred. It was obviously, you know, more work to edit it in that way. It has the same sort of number of deaths around for you to enjoy the death montage of. If that's a thing that people want to enjoy. Look at that. That thing has no friction whatsoever. It's just... Except you can run on it. I don't understand how that's supposed to work at all. If you stand still on it, it just sort of slides under you. It just... I don't get it at all. But anyway, once again, enjoy the montage of me dying. So for this one, what I did was slightly different. Again, what I tended to do, except right at the beginning here, where you see me fail a bunch of times, is I would try to basically delete a run-through, and this I did slightly better. And then what I did was I included the part where I did slightly better, and then there's some goofing around with the fence down there later that you'll get to see. So this one, of course, it ends up deleting a lot more of the runs than the other method that I was using, the other two methods that I was using, but. It didn't, you know, it took me about as long as the other two levels, I think, even though you're not gonna see as much of this level. And also, like I said, I noticed you could jump down here without resetting. So I guess pretty much it checks. There's basically an invisible barrier that checks that if you cross it, that's when the level resets. But these things are above that invisible barrier. So you can go ahead and jump on them all you want. I don't really think there's a way to get back up there, though. So, that's interesting, but... Then I decided to go ahead and restart the thing. And then there's this. Hang on. And then there's this. That is me trying to jump. I am pressing the space bar there, and the guy just wasn't jumping. Again, just not good. But okay, yeah, go ahead and enjoy the montages of me dying, but always getting slightly further along than I did last time. So for this level, I used the same basic strategy, except there was way fewer run-throughs to begin with, because you don't have to mess with the camera for this level. It's all a straight line, so you don't have to worry about changing the camera while there's a platform disappearing underneath your feet, and there's none of those mysteriously frictionless cylinders to deal with. So I did get through this one a lot quicker than the other levels, too. And then there's the strategy I end up using, which is, hey, these things bounce you up in the air when you hit them. I'm gonna go ahead and use that. Thump. 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 And I had one health left here, you can see that up in the corner, so I just jumped normally, but that's it. And then there's this level, which I never did end up finishing. I had been playing by for an hour and a half at this point, and I just figured, whatever. After trying this one for about a half hour, that is. And once again, it has those mysteriously frictionless cylinders, which I hate. Thing is, but it doesn't make you wrestle with a camera at all. So, you know. The thing is, I think this game could be good, like, pretty much, I think I mentioned this in the first episode, but all the Steam reviewers are either, this game sucks, I don't recommend it, or, sarcastic, hey, this is the best game ever, 10 out of 10 game of the year, which is, in a way, its own, non-recommendation of the game, so, it's not just me needing to get better at the game. I never really did figure out how you're supposed to beat this level. Like, the platforms don't seem to really get near enough each other, but that's just how these things go. What I ended up doing after this is I just sort of left it, the game open in the background to collect the rest of the Steam cards, and then I'm pretty much done with it. So we're gonna have a different game for our next Let's Dive In. And I will see you then. As always, you only live once. Thank you.